Yeah, I live in London, obviously, but there is a place where I get to get away, to chill, to disappear off the face of the earth, and I'm going to take you off the beaten path to one very lovely English village called Burnham Market. I want to introduce you to a little corner of England in an area called Norfolk, which is to the east of Great Britain. And this particular town is called Burnham Market. It's one of my favourite places in the whole world. There's a tradition in Norfolk that lots of the houses are made from flint. Well, they're not actually made from flint. The flint is stuck into the wall as a decorational thing. And the other tradition, of course, is Norfolk lavender.
Gorgeous.
I'm going to take you to the best fish shop in the country called Gurney's. Everything's fresh, everything's local. Everything was caught probably today, very early. Oh, I think I might get some lovely sea bass fresh. And these are called cockles. You apparently boil them till they open and then put cider with them and a bit of pepper.
And the moment they open, stop cooking, otherwise they'll go rubbery.
That's the tip of the day. Don't overcook your cockles. Nothing worse than rubbery cockles. The best deli in the whole world is this deli here. It's called Humble Pie. Morning.
Hi.
Oh, now, I suppose the most traditional thing in here is a pork pie, isn't it? And you sell absolutely loads of them.
Tons and tons and tons.
That is such a funny name.
I know.
Dumps a Deary Jam. Yeah. And it's got plums, apples, pears, sugar, cinnamon and cloves in.
Oh, it's really delicious.
Cheers. Who bought this?
You did.
We're in the Host Arms in Burnham Market, which is absolutely the heart of the village. Lord Nelson used to come here every Friday and check in the book to see where he was going to be posted next. It was also a whorehouse years ago, obviously, not now. Hello. I'm going to have a... This is called Norfolk Wherries. It's a traditional... It's a bitter, isn't it? A traditional Norfolk bitter, and it tastes a little bit like, I think it tastes like lavender. Can I have half, please? And is it possible, can I order a cheese ploughman's?
Yeah.
But I suppose you could say it was like a traditional fare for people who would have been ploughing the fields, working on the farms. It would sustain them for the rest of the day, until they went home to their cockles, obviously. Oh, this is gorgeous. Cheers.
I am always drinking pints on these shows.
What's wrong with that?
Now, Harry, I just want to say, I brought you back some Dumps of Deary Jam.
And what is it? What's in here?
There's plums and apples, pears, sugar, cinnamon and cloves.
I didn't know you were going to be here, darling,
so I'm going to give you the gooseberry and lemon chutney.
Give him that, because...
Give him the gooseberry, give me the beer.
I actually want the pickle. When I go there, the first thing I do, we were talking about this, I get a pickle and cheese sandwich.
Cheese and peas. Chicle and peas sounds better.
Yeah,
and then now you're going to tell me you like Marmite.
No, this is delicious, though.
And Bovril.
No, I do not know.
Bovril's beef.
No, I love Marmite. But this is... Smell that. It's delicious. It's like
Dave's,
a sweet onion roll.
Dave's faking English.
Yeah.
No, I'm not kidding. It's genuine.
I was just there this weekend. It's gorgeous. Well, why don't you try a bit? Shall I give you
dress
a bit? Dress British.
That's exactly right. That's my bumper sticker. Like a vault.
Cheesy and strong.
What?
Yes. Your bumper sticker.
Yeah, we were actually just there, weren't you?
Now, let's just have a little bit of cheddar. A little bit of cheddar.
Right.
And a little bit of...
Apple.
Oh, that isn't apple. No. I don't think they're a little bit. You have to have a bite.
Right.
You don't want to ruin your makeup.
There we go.
Different kinds of...
Let me just do, I want you to try some of this pickle.
I want to try some.
This is the pickle stuff?
Yes, it's not the pickle stuff. It's...
Excuse my fingers.
That's all right.
There we go. No, Harry, you have to have it with cheese.
We're putting everything together.
With a bit of cheese, yeah.
Oh, my God.
It is gorgeous.
You stop into any little deli, even into Pret-a-Manger, and you just...
You can get cheese and pickle sandwiches anywhere.
Anywhere.
And then this is a beer.
It is good.
And yummy.
What?
This is good.
It's quite delicious, isn't it?
Oh,
I'll bring you some next time I come, if I'm allowed back, obviously.
Well, we'll see about that.
This is made down the road from me.
Chiswick. Chiswick, our bureau is in Chiswick.
Exactly.
You can smell the hops when you're down there.
I knew there was a reason everyone smelled beer.
And they serve beer there, too.
You see this place.
Yeah, you see it, and you can smell it. It smells like kind of... Do you have Horlicks here, or Ovaltine?
Hollicks.
And it smells like that. Do you have that? No.
No.
It's a bedtime drink. It's malt.
Hollicks?
It smells malty.
Yes. Mm. We used to have Ovaltine when we were kids.
Mm. Oh, they still make Ovaltine.
Yeah.
This is delicious, though. Who needs Ovaltine?
Gorgeous. Thank you very much.
You will have to, if anyone's watching, they'll all have to go to Burnham Market for the summer holidays this year.
You drink You drink your bitters or ale warm, correct? At room temperature.
The bitter, yes.
Yes.
But not the beer, obviously.
Right.
It goes down quicker, I think.
It sure does.
I think I might just have to test it.
Mm-hmm. You got to make sure
it's okay.
Is the FCC watching, or are we cool with this?
Oh, that's lovely. Mm. Mm-hmm. What time is it?
I think it's after 10 p.m., but I've lost track.
It's happy hour somewhere.
It must be cocktail hour in England. But the other thing exactly.
That I think you clued in, though, was the pub culture. As being such a center place for
it
the
really
town.
Is the heart of the village.
People come, they go, they stay, they linger. Mm-hmm. A lot of them get have little gossip. Playgrounds, mm-hmm. you know, for the kids in the back.
Yeah.
There's nothing like that.
No, and that place particularly is the heart of the village and the owner. Oh, man.